Right, okay, hello, it's Polish Paul VR. I think I'm live now, done everything right. Hello, everyone in the chat. Hello, DJ Lynch. Hello, Zraku, Big Coil 07, YouTube, Balloon of Pizza, Pizza, Billy Wade, and everyone else. Nice to see you in the chat. So let's just go over with some announcements and then we're gonna get on with the show. First of all, Saints and Sinners giveaway will be on Sunday during PSVR Super Show, so make sure you tuned in and of course make sure you follow me on Twitter, because that will be the only way I can send you the codes. Of course you can support me on Patreon, you go to patreon.com/polishpolvr, that's where I'm residing. And during today's show we're gonna have a look at Gordon PlayStation VR gameplay, PlayStation 5 graphics, we're gonna talk about Star Wars Vader Immortal and we're gonna talk about Dreams as well. So hello everyone, Max Anderson, Oliver, Bobby Liard, Marty Brayford. Yes, sorry if I cannot read everyone, Lazy Gamer Dog, hello, Haze on 60 FPS. Direhania Ninja, hey from Dire the Ninja, please say hi. Well, I've just done it. So maybe without like being talking too much, I know what you come here for, the most of you anyway, which is of course gameplay for Gorn for PlayStation VR. So what's happening is it looks like codes started going out. Sadly, I didn't got one yet. I don't know if I'm gonna get one or not. If not, I just buy the game and I still gonna do my series like I'm doing with Saints and Sinners. But anyway, my buddy from PlayStation VR Brazil, he's had the game, he's got some gameplay, he said yes, you can use it. So we're gonna have a look. My buddy Roberto, I don't know if his name is Roberto, but you know, Roberto Carlos, one of my favorite footballers of all time, so everyone from Brazil, I just call Roberto. Hello, Tomate, JC Rules, everyone is here. Okay, let me set up this Gorn gameplay, because I must say, let's hope it won't crash the stream. Okay, that's on the screen. Let me go to my place now. And now, boop. There we go, the Gorn for PlayStation VR. Maybe let's make it a bit smaller so you can see it better. So this is the Gorn. The quality of this video is a bit low. Oh, it's all right, it's fixed itself. So this is Gorn, how it plays on PlayStation VR. Tell me what you're thinking. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to PSVR Brazil, especially if you're from Brazil and want to have your content in the Spanish. Is it Spanish they speak in Brazil? I think so. Language, I don't know. But anyway, everything what you're seeing on the screen at the moment is from PlayStation VR version. Now this video is kind of ripped from YouTube, so it looks a bit more blurry. Let me see if I can actually upgrade the quality of it, because no, it's 720p. So yeah, that's what you see is what you get. But from what he said, Moodman, I'm feeling all right. Gorn's gonna be great. So yeah, hey, what's up, Paul? All good. PSVR Brazil, he's here, he's the man. Go to his channel if you want to see full video with commentary. Nice one, dude, thanks for providing us with gameplay. This is something we was waiting for a while. I've got my cursor here, but God, so many of you just likes the Gorn. But as I played the game on PC, I kind of knew what to expect, and I must say, I cannot really see the difference from the PC version in the PSVR version. They retain that movement when you can grab yourself and put yourself around the stage. All the weapons physics and character physics, all, look how much his head is blasted. It all looks the same, so that's nice. Okay, let's see what's in comment section, what we've got. Elephant, wasn't Final Assault is in country? Yeah, it should have Final Assault, just keep in mind price is wrong, it's too expensive. Somebody made good point on Reddit, when the Saints and Sinners price was too cheap, they fix it straight away. When the games tend to be more expensive, they not fixing it straight away. So let's see how long it's gonna take them. Okay, who else is there? Diego, hey Paul, should I buy the Oculus Quest? I don't know, I don't own Quest, I've got a Rift, but I'm hearing Quest is very good. Vids is gone out. No, it's not. Hey Paul, what's this about Vader Immortal? Just bit of info, just some art for PlayStation VR version. We're gonna get to it a bit later. Will we be able to turn off those boundaries? I have no idea, but PSVR Brazil is in chat, so he might be able to answer you. I'm assuming the boundaries are here, so you know how to set up your camera. So it looks like kind nip PSVR. Hey, Paul, I got a question about The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners. What about voice immersion option? I don't think it's here yet, is it? I'm sure they said it might be something they'd be adding, but it's not here yet. You're welcome, PSVR Brazil, no problem. Very fun gameplay. Sometimes I pop in to streams. I think I watched your Vigilant Ranger stream as well. I think so, I don't know. When that come out, by the way, Vigilant Ranger, pff, terrible. Okay, what's about Gorn? The weapons seem more blunt. See if it's one for one chase. Oh, look at that, it's me on screen. So the weapons, from what I'm seeing here, like this hammer, it's wobbles same as on PC, and they all seem the same. The physics look, to me, they look exactly the same, and this is a proper PSVR gameplay. So I don't think they any different. Gorn, PSVR release data. I'm assuming it's date. Bratan Dark Spooky Mystic asking. That's going to be with you on 19th of May. Stanisław Rzeczkowski, hello. Diego, the firm release date is on 19th, that's right. What is the price of Gorn? It's gonna be $19.99. Wait, I didn't change this. Text on the bottom. Gone PSVR game apply. There we go. That's just like bit better. There we have it. Stick to the middle. That's it. Okay, so Mr. Timonator 47. Gone next Tuesday then? Yes, next Tuesday. That is the day. Isaac England, best PSVR news in the game. Keep it up, Paul. Thanks. You're welcome. Not a problem. Anything else about Gorn? Do you, Bratan Dark Spooky Mystic, do you speak Polish? If yes, can you say something like, hello, Bratan, you are nice person, or something, something. Cześć, Bratan, jesteś fajną osobą, albo coś, there we go, Polish. Oliver Milner, VR chat, I'm being asked about it weekly, it's not coming. PSVR Brazil, Gaming Chan, I've received promotional call from the developer in Brazil. Right, well, I didn't, and I'm waiting, but I'm not often get codes. I didn't have codes for Saints and Sinners, but I don't mind. I just gonna get gone if I don't get code. Saying that, Saints and Sinners PR company, after I've done some videos, they contacted me, they said, hey, Paul, have some codes now. So I've took them, and I was thinking, yes, I'm gonna do giveaway. So, of course, the giveaway Sunday in the PSVR Super Show. Will Tuber plays for Gorn in the UK? That should be about 15 quid, something like that. Oh, wait, we need to fast forward stream. There was some issues. There we go. Okay, now what else we've got? Chapulin Cat, PSVR Brazil, how are the controls? Yes, I would like to know from what I saw on stream. So he was using this pulling option, what I always use on PC, so you don't even need thumbsticks, you just pull yourself around the stage. That's the first control option they've had, and it's most immersive as well, so I advise, yeah, try this option, because that's the best option. Is that... that wait, yeah, that's right. Even though it's a bit slower, it's just... it makes you very tired, but also makes you more immersed. Denzonian, the weapons are looking really weak. I keep seeing times in the footage where a body part should be way more damage. But they either do nothing or have little scratch on them. Anyone else thinks this? I think that's done on purpose. The weapons got very rubbery feel. I think that hammer you can hold with the both hands. Okay, what's Max Andersol? Still wondering what's that blue stuff around the weapon. So that's your camera boundaries, so depends how you set up your camera, you can see boundaries or not. PSVR Brazil, the movement is like speed vector, that's right. Mr. Timonator, thank you very much. Oliver Milner, any updates on Drunken Bar Fight? I think they released updates, they're working on another level, and that will be coming eventually. Mortada Monaf, does The Walking Dead allow mods? Sadly, don't, not on PSVR anyway. Will Tuber, thank you very much. how did he get to play Red Bean Guy? So this is not my gameplay, that from PSVR Brazil. It's on his channel, so go check it out. But he's had the code from the developers. So was it 24-bit studio what ported it to PlayStation VR, I'm assuming. Is that a Brazilian studio? So Free Lives was the developer, the Devolver was publisher, and 24-bit studio was the company what ported it to PlayStation VR. And that's what they do, they port in the games, they're doing some porting works, and they've done very well with this port. It looks pretty cool. Okay, what else we got? Isimner mode coming to Stunt Sinners, Saints and Sinners. Oscar Lonergan, they said they just winked at us with a winky face, so it looks like they might be adding it. Dominic Muffin, hello, welcome the mods in the chat. I'm back from my Saints and Sinners plea. Yes, I've been playing some more today for tomorrow's video. Very addictive game, but I tell you what, Gorn is not bad at all as well. What else, man? Denzonian, I meant like they seem more weaker than the PC version, weapons still got target the game. They won't be weaker, all the physics and everything are exactly the same. It might be because it's beginning of the game as well, yeah? So you get some more better weapons later on also. Who else is there? Sick Fool. I really hope Saints and Sinners get more items, random spawn items to collect. I loved it, but there is no real endgame. Right, yeah, so they said they're working on more content, so what they gonna do? I do not know. Hey, Paul, will be able to pre-order God? It would be great to know. Max 09872. Book it. So, what they said is no. You're not be able to pre-order God, you're just gonna have to go to store, buy it, and wait for it to download. By the way, breaking news, speaking about downloads. So whoever been longer with this channel, you know, in my old house, before I moved into this house, I mean now, my internet was super slow. I was hoping when I move in this house, I'd be able to get fiber internet. I moved in and I couldn't because there was not enough slots. So I had to wait basically for someone to move out or cancel their internet or die. And what's happened lately, somebody must have, well, moved out, canceled it or died because there was available slot. So I was running this channel on 4G internet mobile, yeah? That's how it was running. I've had like mobile 4G router and everything. Upload speeds was alright, but download speed wasn't very good. So what's happened is I'm gonna get fiber now. Max Anderson, wow, thank you for the donation. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you very much. It helps the channel a lot. Some of you knows I'm trying to get new capture card because my capture card is alright for reviews, but it's not working with my laptop. I've got that Avermedia one, which is supposed to be best. So that's what I went with. I wish I had Elgato because that was definitely work. So I'm gonna get myself Elgato so you can see me on streams and have footage without those corners of the screen black. So thanks again, Max. That's gonna go towards this. Michael Swifty 99, hello, Dominic Muffy, a day before that, I think he's answering to someone. Okay, so where is the gameplay from? Henry X asking. The gameplay is from PSVR Brazil channel. As you know, I'm subscribed to pretty much all PlayStation VR channels. And he's had his code from the developer. I think it's porting studio, I just spoke about it. Now this, what he's doing now, I've been doing clothes on PC because you just like to bash the bodies. But also what's gonna happen when you mess around and gone like that, you're gonna discover something hilarious. And that's what's gonna happen in Gorn. You like playing this game and you've got those weapons and you think, yes, I can just bash people heads in and everything. But then you always discover something funny, some new ways to kill. So this game is one of those games what just keep on giving the longer you're playing. So amazing. Right, okay, what else? I hate they close off church area at the end. Would be cool if they turned it into a massive horde mode. Oh, I didn't know if they closed off. I actually, in the church area during my tomorrow playthrough, what I gonna publish, I keep dying there, so I kind of rage quitted at the end, but I gonna do it. So tomorrow's video is gonna be a mission and a half, I think, for Saints and Sinners. Andreas XLA, Paul, can we move on? Like to Vader Immortal. Sorry for the bad patience. We will move on in a minute, but I still, you know, for people who popping in, They want to see Gorn, we saw fighting. This is like how you go to the arenas, what he's doing now. So I think he's going to do the boss fight now, yes? Or is that locked yet? Oh no, he's gonna fight Goliath. So what's the bosses in there? Krabs, Goliath, Achilles, what else was there? I think them faces from crowd flying at you. I can't remember all the boss fights. Neil, no worries, and thanks for popping in. I shall see you tomorrow. Sparky Boy 120. What's the blue thing? That's the boundaries for PlayStation VR. So I think that's what I'm assuming from the stream. So there you go. This is 200 weapon now. So basically, you don't. That's it. His camera, I think, was a bit low. So. Yeah, so that's the all the rubbery feeling of the weapon. So because it's not PC, of course, so you don't have 360 tracking. So I think the game wants you to like know where you are and what you're doing. How long has Gorn been around on PC? Billy Wade, I think. Oh, hard to tell. Was it like 2016? When they launch early access and they've been working on it, but like 1.0 version, the proper full version of Gorn released last year in summer, I think. What else? Question, blue things. Yeah, play area, that's right. Deadpool Stormtrooper, this looks amazing. For sure, I'm impressed how much it looks like PC version. And PSVR Brazil says it looks really sharp as well, so that's nice. What else? STN Katie, I don't speak English very well. Can you tell me what does giveaway mean? STN Katie, don't worry, I don't speak English very well, but giveaway means that I'm gonna give away the game. So on Sunday in PSVR Super Show, I'm gonna give away Saints and Sinners, not just one copy, but two copies. They send me two games, so that's what I'm gonna do. So that's gonna be Sunday sorted, so I hope somebody wins. Denzonian, this seems awesome, but I just have one complaint. The boundaries are so annoying. I hope we can turn them off. I don't know. You can ask PSVR Brazil if he's still in chat. Maybe you can. I don't know. I didn't saw him going to options. But I know what you mean. It all depends on camera placement, of course, but like in my new house, I'm not properly set up yet because we don't live in room and everything. But where my camera is, it's kind of close to me as well, so I probably gonna get those boundary signs. I need to actually set myself properly, even though I've been in this new house nearly a year. Right, who else you got? Francesco, the gamer. Are you giving away mod positions? I've been every stream. Not yet, but if I need mods, I definitely give you shout. Yeah, Grass Scooter is sick. Oh yeah, you Max Anderson, so who unlocked Grass Scooter in Saints and Sinners? What else we got? Captain Jimmy, are you excited for Gorn, Paul? Captain Jimmy, 1, 2, 3, 4? Of course I am excited, I cannot wait, I definitely gonna play it. The game is just amazing. I like it on PC as well, but I didn't play it for a while. With my PC setup, I need to always set up sensors and everything, it just gets annoying. And then I have to reset all tracking, so you know, PC might be alright if you keep it in one place, but if you like me and don't have enough room, because I just did baby's room, so that room gone from me now forever, because of course the baby is due in 2 months time, so yeah, I need to set it all up, so I'm barely touching PC now. Last time I played on PC, I played GTA 5 with a mod for VR, PSVR Brazil, yes, there is a costume mode too, nice. Mark, hello. Spark Attack, hello. Dominic Muffin says hello to Mark as well. So I'm just watching this gameplay because I missed some of the stream. And I'm really liking what I'm seeing. Them two-handed weapons. They best be in hold, two-handed. Bash, his head is gone. Right. Spoofly Greenman. What are the mods, I mean, for the stream? Mods are Spoofly Greenman, I never can say this name. Like Dominic Muffin above you. He's checking that everyone behaves, nobody's spamming or being nasty or bullying anyone. So that's what mods doing, and I really appreciate hard work by the mods. So it does helps a lot with me running when I do live stream like that. Of course, I struggle to mod, especially if I live streaming from PlayStation VR. I cannot mod at all and delete any comments. So that's what they're doing, and they really very, very helpful. So big shout out to mods. Oliver Milner, is The Walking Dead Onslaught coming soon? Right, so Let me check, Oliver, because I've been speaking to the developers. Let me check on Twitter what is with the onslaught. Let me go to my messages. Where are they? Saints and Sinners. Onslaught, onslaught. I think I spoke about it actually in my news video. Right, so with Saints and Sinners. So they're not giving us date. What they're saying is, yes, it's still confirmed for PSVR, Steam and Oculus. I can still only say it's coming this year. No more release dates, news beyond that. Our devs are heads down on it. So they're working on it. I'm assuming they're waiting a bit, you know, for hype of Saints and Sinners to go down. But definitely, eventually it will happen. So I think they can ride kind of wave of Saints and Sinners as well. Because of course they are two different games. Even they are Walking Dead games, Saints and Sinners is single player, while Onslaught is focused on multiplayer and co-op. So that will be nice. So let me grab a drink. Billy White, congratulations on your baby, Paul. I'm sure you will be a great dad and you're really down to earth person and you have a great sense of humor. Oh, thanks, Billy White. Very nice comment, very kind of you, and I appreciate it. Gordon looks good for PSVR, LA say, yes, it does. Let me get a think of water. What else you got? People asking question to PSVR Brazil. Probably the most lucky man on earth at the moment, playing Gorn already. Mark Rothborn, will you be playing form as a gameplay walkthrough? So with Gorn, I'm gonna do same what I'm doing with Saints and Sinners. I'm having so much fun making those videos. They just nice to edit and nice to make. So yeah, definitely. I'm gonna try to do it more with bigger games. Probably I do same with Iron Man. I'm gonna try to do same with After the Fall as well, because that's a quite a big game coming. Zero Caliber maybe. So yeah, I'm planning to have quite few series now. So this is my Saints and Sinners series continues. Right, Jack Jackson, how long is The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners? As long as you make it, you can finish it in like 5 hours. If you notice in my live streams, sorry. If you noticed in my live streams, I'm taking it slowly, so for me gonna be longer, but I just don't want to finish it too early. I was thinking, you know what, when you do Lunin PSVR channel doing reviews, you kind of rushing through the games, you know, to put up review and then move on to another game, and then you don't have time to like enjoy the game and doing gameplay walkthroughs, and because enough people watching it, it just lets me take my time and enjoy the game. I've done review in progress. I'm gonna do proper review as well, but it's so much better doing it that way. I know it's meant I have to skip Pixel Ripped 1995, but I might come back to this game. So yeah, it's super awesome. Okay, what else you got here? Is Gone God Candy Mode, Mark Rothborn asking. Yes, it does. Pinata Mode is here, definitely. Okay, what else? Miroslav Baskovic. Is Aspyr 1 fixed now? I picked it up and waiting for Assimilation update. It's a lot more fixed than it was when it's first released, so definitely a much better game. Assimilation update will be coming soon as well. Vegeta VR, what's up, Paul? All good, we're checking out Gorn PSVR gameplay. I'm leaving it hanging here for a while. We've got video from PSVR Brazil. He's having fun. He's the happy person playing Gorn already. We all, of course, very jealous, but for now we can enjoy his gameplay, which is pretty cool because, like I said, pretty much one-to-one conversion from the PC. How long this stream be? Because I have to go to bed. I have no idea. I usually try to keep those about an hour, but they usually becoming longer than that, so I don't know. Hello everyone, Josh Gay, fact. Right, okay, Hutol, I don't have Pixel Ripped yet. Yeah, me either, but I get it eventually. Andreas XLA, Paul, are you a dad? Well, guess what, I gonna be a dad in July, 15th of July, I think is the date of the baby coming. So yeah, very soon, 2 months, and yeah, baby gonna have to find a way to look after the baby and run the channel, but I tell you what, I become the master in doing proper like time management. especially with my work, working so much, I'm just so organized when it comes to channel, nothing else. What else? Oliver, will you make series on Gore? Yes, I will, definitely. Do you think Saints and Sinners is worth it? Worth it, and I love your videos. Mercy, definitely worth it, 100%. Get it, don't even think about it. What else we've got? Congrats, thank you very much. Yes, the baby girl, it's a girl coming, the name it chosen is Malena. Okay, where will Gone come out? I see Lemon asking. It will come out on 19th. Is it a boy or a girl? I just said it's a girl. Congratulations. Thank you very much. Noob TV, do you play Gone? No, I didn't play it yet, but Luckiest Guy on Earth, PSVR Brazil, that's from his channel. He's played it. The link should be in the description. Did I put link in the description? Actually, I can't remember. I'm gonna have to add it after the stream. But just type in the search PSVR Brazil and his channel comes up. When Gone coming out to PSVR, I forgot, 19th. What do you work as? I'm a carer, so now I work more because of course coronavirus. But hey, what can you do? Congrats, thank you. Does Gone have crouch button? Oh, I don't know, PSVR Brazil, if he's still in stream, he might answer. I don't know what time is now in Brazil, might be super late, so I don't know if he's still awake. Are the weapons supposed to be floppy? Of course, that's how they always was in Gone. That's part of fun of it. Thank you for all the congratulations, Jock Jackson, thanks. Of course, I'm gonna always keep you updated forever, as long as this channel is live. I love your Saints and Sinners, they are so funny, keep them up. Yes, I'm gonna edit another one after I do this, which gonna be up hopefully tomorrow on the channel. Chapulin Cat, yes, I think I should get ready. Hopefully it won't be too much drama and hopefully I'm gonna have some time to still play some PSVR and do news videos for you. How does he play Gone on PSVR? Vegeta VR, he's had the key from the porting studio, which I think is Brazilian studio, but I'm not 100% sure. I know Free Lives, who made the game, are in Africa, but 24-bit games ported it. And I think they're from Brazil, I'm not sure. Oliver Milner, how do you move in Gone? So there's different movement options. The default option is, which is the best options for me as well, it's like what he does as well. So it's kind of combination of, as he said, sprint vector, but you have to press triggers and you pull in yourself around the stage. So you don't even need thumbsticks, not even on PC. But of course you can change it if that makes you too tired. Have you already talked about Vader Immortal? No, I think Vader Immortal will be next. Not much news about Vader, but a bit, and I'm gonna talk about it. Got to go, Paul, goodbye. Okay, Kane, thanks for popping in. What's better, Saints and Sinners or Gone in your opinion? Well, they are totally two different games, and Gone, don't forget, is half price, the Saints and Sinners. But also, for me personally, now Saints and Sinners is the best game in VR and on PlayStation VR, so of course I'm gonna have Saints and Sinners if I had to choose one. Okay, who else you got? I'm going, Mercy, I'm going to get the game. Congrats with the baby. And what is your favorite game? So yeah, like I said, it is Saints and Sinners at the moment, but I do like Gone. I love Hellblade in VR as well, but that's only on PC. What else I like? Blood and Truth, of course. Golem, amazing game, I love Golem, so plenty of them. PSVR Brazil gets the questions. Is PSVR, Timira, this is from PSVR, yes, let me move the cursor of the screen. Vegeta VR, this is my first time on your live stream. Oh, thanks for popping in, this first time for everything. What's the blue that appears around his hands? This is the boundaries for your camera, so you know where you are. I've spoken about it on PC VR, you've got 360 tracking, on PSVR sadly not. So I'm assuming it's kind of like you've got in Farpoint as well, they've got that system. I don't know if on PSVR you can switch it off or not. PSVR Brazil, no, at Polish Pol VR. The Brazilian PR of the Devolver distributor has... Oh, right, nice one. I wish there was English one somewhere to send me, or Polish, I don't know, I'm Polish, but I live in England. Who should I go for? Who else? Jock Jackson. I'm going to buy The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners tomorrow, Paul. I can't wait to play it. Nice one, you will enjoy it. Amazing game. What else you got? What's the Bluetooth? Yes, so that's the camera. Philstar, the game card. Welcome back in the stream. is Paul Flight, Green Man, who disliked it? I have no idea, but it wasn't me. Okay, but anyway, we've had half hours of gore, now let's move on to Star Wars. So, thanks again to PSVR Brazil, make sure you check out his channel, he's provided us with some footage. So, wait, I'm in the wrong spot here. Managing 10 things at once. Okay, oh, by the way, did you saw what Sony put up for their studios? They all gonna have this logo now, very nice. Reach 100 likes, Dominic says. Thank you very much. Have you seen new PSVR footage? I gonna see it again in a minute. We're gonna talk about it. But for now, let's check out. So what happened with Star Wars is Star Wars. That's the Star Wars. Of course, there's no PSVR trailer now, so that's from the Rift. Let me just change the text. Oh, spelling mistakes. Immortal. There you go. Of course, it seems to be perfectly in the middle. Is that perfect? Kind of. So, Star Wars Vader Immortal. Let's talk a bit about that. Of course, got announced last week, which was super awesome. We all got excited. Last week was just such a good week. We've had Saints and Sinners released, Ghost Recon release date, and then Star Wars Vader Immortal got announced. And even this week, Iron Man VR got announced. I'm assuming the closer it gets to E3, the more announcements we're gonna have. But anyway, Star Wars Vader Immortal, developers said it's coming in summer. They didn't tell us when, but they showed us today how the game art for PlayStation VR gonna look like. I'm not sure if it's just for digital or if they're gonna look the if they're gonna do the physical edition of the game. Hopefully, that's what I'm hoping for. So I'm gonna let's just look at this trailer a bit more, and I'm gonna show you this this art for PlayStation VR version. It's gonna available for PS, for Noob TV asking. Yes, it will be on 19th. Chapulin Cat, PSVR Brazil, thanks again. Yeah, definitely, muchly appreciated. We all happy that we saw your gameplay, we all could look. And now we know that the Gorn buying it on PSVR is pretty safe because it's like one-to-one port from PC. Dominic Muffin, I'm not going to be able to buy the next PSVR headset, so I'm going to have to switch to PC VR. Next PSVR headset is probably still a few years away, but I would wait with switching. I got PC VR, I think they're all pretty much the same, so you know, all the little, only thing I would change on PSVR, even if they couldn't get rid of light tracking right now, if they just added thumbsticks, I would be happy with it. But saying that, it's working fine with the PlayStation VR. 1000 Russian rubles is 11 pound in Russian rubles. Thank you, that was my donation, so I appreciate it. Definitely gonna get myself this new capture card so I can have like my Let's Plays them gameplay series with me on the screen with nice footage. Like I said, I've got other media capture card and I wish I didn't bought it. It's good piece of equipment because it's you press one button and it records straight to laptop. But it's not work for my live stream and for me with my face on the, you know, on the screen with the sound. So I cannot do it. I have to use my PSVR microphone and headset at the moment, but you're still watching, so thank you very much. Anyway, what I meant to show you is the art for PSVR version. Wait, I'm sure I downloaded it. Star. Now I can't find it. The preparations wasn't very good. Give me a second. Give me a second. We get it sorted. Star Wars. No. No. Oh. Okay, where did I download it? The one thing I want to show you. I got some stuff there. Oh dear. Right, let's find it in the folder. open location today. Yeah. Let's see if I can do it that way. I don't know why, but my streaming software won't open it. All files. Right, let's see. So it goes to black screen. Right, I would have to quickly edit it, which I'm gonna do because I don't mind. Let me just come back to the Star Wars. It's only gonna take a second. Just keep chatting, keep chatting. Let's play different trailer, maybe, perhaps. What's in the chat? Thank you for the answers. You're welcome. Can we get Mr. Beast in the live? I don't think he popping into my live streams. I wonder how much Vader Immortal will cost. Yeah, it's. I'm assuming it's gonna be around 30, because on the PC is on the it's like three of them, and one of them cost about £9 each, so 9 × 3 quid maths 27. So my best guess is around 30. Right. Okay. Let me just try to get you this Star Wars thing on the screen. Right, I'm gonna do this. Actually, I can do just that. Not like making a video while doing a live stream. Okay, we're gonna save it here. Under the name Star Wars. Save. Come on, do it. Star Wars. You can't save here. What do you mean I can't? Right. Star Wars. Okay, doing, it's needed on, pew, 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 done. Okay, so now I can do it. What's in the chat? Sounds good. When release date? What for Star Wars? I don't know. Hey, Paul, sorry I'm late. Jack JV 123 30, that's great, yeah. So 30 for all the episodes, by the way, yeah? All that we get in all of them at once. Star Wars. Okay, yeah, there we go. So that's the PlayStation VR key art. There's a little logo at the bottom of PlayStation VR. Now they release that key art. I don't know if it's for the store, for PlayStation Store. God, wish hairdressers open soon. Or are we getting physical edition? That's what I want to ponder about it in the stream. So we're just gonna have to see. Can we make Paul read my comment and name? I read your comments, but will I read your name? I am made out of star stuff. I've done it. Okay, what else you got? I'm scared gone will be $20 or will be fair. It will be $19.99. Wait, Paul, did you do giveaways? Stepan, I didn't do giveaway yet. I not done one for a while, but since I bought Saints and Sinners and they sent me codes just now, I gonna give it away on my live show on Sunday, so make sure you follow me on Twitter, because only on Twitter I can send you the codes, yeah? So just be on my Twitter somewhere there. Paul, you are the best PSVR YouTuber. Thanks, you Ninja Master. Good night, have a nice week. Okay, thank you, you too. Andreas, XLA, I really want Kingspray for PSVR. You know that graffiti game. I know we have Google Steelbrush, but I like graffiti better. Right, from last one, I spoke to Kingspray devs. I'm gonna tell you what they actually said. Let me just find my messages to them. I've got them. I've been talking to the, just finding it. That's the troubles. So let's have a look at the Kingspray. Just so hard to find messages in my Kingspray. Right. Okay. So I spoke to them after they released the version for the Quest, yeah? And that's what they said when I said, well, if it's on Quest, will it come to PlayStation VR? They said, yeah, I know, I want it on PSVR as well. Oh, shit, I nearly disliked that message, I don't know why. Good to hear you get a chance to give it away. So, oh yeah, that's for when I've been playing PC version, hopefully you like it. I recommend you get it on Steam and opt into the dev branch if you do. Crap, no, don't do it. And join the, okay, so that's the, okay, so. Now regarding PSVR version. Hey Paul, still no movement on the PSVR, sorry. Their free quest made it more feasible, but still haven't gotten stuck into it in earnest. Right, so they wanted to do King's Play. I think it's tracking what they've got problem. They not say they're not gonna do it, but I don't know, we might have to wait. Okay, what else we got? Thank you very much, Mortida. Since 100 subs, early days of the channel. With the old microphone, me not being on screen, being on screen, then not being on screen. Is it PS4? What's that? Vader Immortal, that's for PS4. But anyway, now what we're gonna watch live, we're gonna move on to another subject now. I'm gonna play a video, let us all watch it. Of course, I'm gonna comment on it a bit, because Unreal Engine did the showcase of PlayStation 5 graphics. Now, if some of you watched the Xbox when they've been doing presentation of their Xbox Series X, the future Xbox, many people was disappointed because they pretty much showed nothing, not even proper gameplay from Xbox. Instead, they've been saying it's a targeted graphics, targeted how they want to look like. But targeted means it was all captured on PC. While today, Sony not even done anything. Unreal, they just posted video which was running on PlayStation 5 and the graphics are out of this world. So let's just play it and I'm gonna watch it with you and comment on it. Of course, can't find anything as always. Okay, so there it is. Let me just turn the sound up. So you can kind of hear me, but keep pressing wrong thing. But also I want you to hear them as well. So tell me if it's too loud or not. Because I can't hear the sound, so I got no sound levels. Let me know properties. Okay, so here we have it. They're just talking what's in the engine. I hope you can hear it all right. Well, now it won't be in the middle getting there. There you go. We're gonna keep it like that. Just tell me how it sounds. Can you hear them and can you hear me? Budget cuts delayed to next month. Shook head. Hello, I just watched before I did that stream your Saints and Sinners review. Nice to see you nice to see you back and hope you're doing well. That's what I meant to say. As always, of course, quality review, pal. By the way, Shookhead had little break from YouTube, but he's back now. Was it like 4 months, you said? So anyway, this is the graphics. It's low, the sound is low, the sound is low. Okay, let's do it. Let me know how it is now. Is it louder? I know the comments are delayed, but that's the only way I know about the sound. So I try not to talk too much during this because I'm hoping you want to listen to it, but this is everything you've seen is on PS5. And thanks to virtual texturing, they all use 8K textures as well. It's pretty quiet still. They are super quiet. Okay.
There are over a billion triangles of source geometry in each frame that Nanite crunches down losslessly to around 20 million drawn triangles. What does that many triangles look like?
No problem.
This isn't noise.
See you later.
These are the triangles, each a different color. Most are so small that they look like noise. Nanite achieves detail down to the pixel, which means triangles are often the size of pixels.
Finally got it right. Now I
this
have
amount
to remember
of geometric
this
detail requires shadows to be pixel accurate as well. And Nanite can do that too. Oof. Speaking of lighting, all of the lighting in this demo is completely dynamic, with the power of Lumen that even includes multi-bounce global illumination. No light maps,
sure, yeah,
no baking here.
Very interesting how
without
they
GI,
things.
All of that beautiful
nice.
Lighting
I'm
is
gonna
gone.
Save those settings.
With
Hopefully
Lumen enabled, we can move the light and the bounce changes instantly. Okay, let's keep going.
Arcan, I didn't got there yet, but some missions attached to me as well.
We've made some great additions to our audio system as well.
I like how they made it look like a demo, like a game.
Convolution Reverb measure reverberation characteristics of real
spaces. It's all running on PlayStation 5.
Like actual 5. Caves that we sampled, and reproduce them in virtual space.
Amazing soon.
Sound field rendering allows us to record and play back spatialized audio.
Since PlayStation 2, I'm
all of this adds up to a more immersive experience.
Mac 47, yeah, that's gonna be end of this month, so about 2 weeks away now. Sort of gargantua.
This swarm of bats was created with our Niagara effects system.
Particles
in Niagara
XLA
can now talk to
well
one
said
another and understand their environment like never before.
Reggie Swan, yeah, just rewind its first story of this theme, so just rewind and you'll be able to see.
We've also added a ton of new functionality to run fluid simulations like you see in the water below. Demo runs on our Chaos
well
physics
said,
system. Here we are using it to
comments,
accurately simulate the rigid bodies of the falling rocks and the cloth of her
it's
scarf.
It's gonna be awesome. I wish they showed us some PSVR games. I'm sure they will eventually, probably very soon. About 15 quid, Oliver.
Now that the environment is so complex, we've needed to greatly improve our animation systems to adapt. We've added predictive foot placement and motion warping, which dynamically modifies IK and body position to look more natural. For the character to more realistically
like
interact with the environment, we've added the ability to trigger seamless contextual animation events, like her hand on the door.
That's promising.
Dynamic GI is amazing, not just for speeding up iteration, but also for its impact on gameplay.
Nice.
Any light source can move
just
while still having beautiful
light
bounce
effects
lighting.
And you can see the bugs as well running
dynamic
away.
Dynamic illumination means specular as well, which you can see on all the metal surfaces.
They've done some magic here.
You can even see the Niagara-powered bugs reacting to the light.
That's what Microsoft should show off in
Lumen
their presentation,
not only reacts
something
to moving
like
light
this
sources, but also
it would
changes
that
in
well
geometry
so much better. Even when the ground breaks, look how light shines when it breaks through those light.
Remember
light,
we mentioned high poly assets? This statue was imported directly from ZBrush and is more than 33 million triangles. No baking of normal maps, no authored LODs.
There we go, Shuk tells you
and we can
down
do more
that's
than a single statue.
Happen.
There are nearly 500
I think
of that
it's
exact
be very,
statue
very big leap
at the same detail level
everything
placed in this room for a total of over 16 billion triangles from statues alone.
And then with Xbox 360 and PS3
over this
and
entire
PS4
demo,
and Xbox
there are
One,
hundreds
it's kind
of
graphics been getting triangles better a lot, you know, but it wasn't such a big leap as it is now, so we should all get excited. I mean, look at the detail on everything. It's insane.
So with Nanite, you have limitless geometry, and with Lumen, you have fully dynamic
that's
lighting and global illumination.
All the light
all running
through
on a PlayStation 5.
Daniel definitely is gonna be awesome. I mean, it's all rendered in real time. And as we know, the longer console is out, the more advantage the developer gets, and so it's that, that's the start to see how much better things will get. RDS XLA, definitely. I don't think this is a proper game that's gonna come out. This is just the demo that put together, but
there's
I would play that.
And this doesn't need to be constrained to small rooms. It can stretch all the way to the horizon.
And this is great. Just look outside.
Portal, it's open.
So much detail in everything.
Don't fail me now.
And she's off. Nice motion there. Can we use PSVR and PS5 to do it? It's gonna work.
it's time to see what's next.
Yes, definitely getting stronger. It's been also always another great in the FPR. But you know, legend-wise, many good ones. This isn't really anything I would definitely believe someone if they said this. It's all in real time, running on PlayStation 5, in Unreal Engine 5. Coming 2021. Not PlayStation 5, the Unreal Engine coming 2021. Okay, I'm gonna turn it down a bit.
Now, hello, I'm Brian Karras, technical.
Not just starting from beginning. So, what's happening is Unreal announced it, looks amazing. Of course, Sony's first party studios, I don't know what they'd be able to extract from PlayStation 5, but just imagine Naughty Dog, what they'd be able to do. Shookhead Gaming, start saving people. I am betting PS5 will be close to $700. They should bundle the new system with a PSN membership and sell it like phones with a monthly membership. Maybe, I don't know. I'm still gonna get it no matter the price, but I'm hoping around 500 would be more affordable for everyone. I don't see it myself to be any lower than 500, that's minimum. But like Shookhead says, might be about 700. Nobody knows, we just have to wait. And speaking about waiting, the rumors saying that there is going to be PlayStation 5 event in June. But that just rumors, but also maybe. I think, you know, rumors often not true. And with June, when E3 should happen, somebody might just made it up. I don't know. But regarding the release month for PlayStation VR, apparently it's only been listing the jobs offerings for people to apply, and they've been saying in this job listing, so this is leaked from Sony themselves, they leaked the release month for PS5, and this release month apparently is October, so that's what the job listing is saying, so hopefully May till October, 5 months, I could not wait longer. Okay, let's see what's comment saying. Andreas XL8, but the question is, can we take past PS4 game discs and play them on PS5. Yes, they already said that we can. Githood, can we use PS4 VR in PS5? Yes. Boy Brown, think how good Drunken Bar Fight 2 will be on PS5 and PSVR 2, lol. Yeah, what they would change in Drunken Bar Fight. Daniel Michen, yeah, that will definitely be pretty good for VR. Denzonian, I am very hard to impress. Shookhead, same price as PS1 when taking into account inflation. Yeah, that's correct. Boy Brown said, would be suicide. I think, I don't know, those days, like Shookhead said, when you account for inflation, I mean, when, what was NES, yeah, first Nintendo system, was that like $400 back in 1983 or something, which would be like Ninja Grand today, and still loads of people bought it. But I know we used to, what Sony did last gen, they went very low with the price, so I don't know if they'd be able to repeat it. But you know what, I hope everyone be able to save it somehow and buy it. Oliver, they are making Drunken Bar Fight 2? Probably not, but they're making a new level. Max Undersold, well, who told you that? Monster Parts, I paid $699 for the PS4, the Christmas is came out. Was it $699? That expensive, unless there was shortages. Need to change my position. And I get my bald head up. Okay, what else? Boy Brown, yes. Camp. Definitely we are in the recession, probably even gonna get worse. Xbox 360 and PS3 kind of released during the recession. And they all nearly sold the same, while Nintendo Wii just outsold everyone and everyone used it 5 times and stopped playing as well. Right, okay. How PS6 would look like? Yes, I'd be like 50 when PS6 releases. Actually, I paid 5 for PS4 when it came out, right? What else? Epic Gamer, hello! Spotlight Gaming, I'ma get it into matter the price. No matter the price. Yeah, same here. I'm gonna get it. Well, I'm gonna have to have, you know, on the channel the best things, of course. Daniel Mitchell, games are at the point where they look nicer than real life. Yeah, I mean, look at that. I mean, that character, I don't know, it's kind of look cartoonish, but when you look at the environment, definitely looks amazing. Okay, what else we've got here? I think that's it about this. So let's talk about Dreams. That's about PS5 graphics. What we have time? We've got 4 minutes left until the hour, so we're probably gonna get a few minutes overtime, as we always do. Mythical creature, I'm going to get gone the day it comes out, just as I did when Walking Dead Saints and Sinners comes out. Yes, very good. Okay, so the Dreams, not much new, but they put out nice new trailer. So let's just look at it. Dreams. Oh, I've got so many. Okay. Hey, what about that? Wait a minute. Let's just play it. Can't hear it. Who's recognized it already? Let's play it with sound.
Hit her. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark. Hit her. It's not true. It's bullshit. I did not hit
Mark.
Her. I did not.
Anyway.
Oh, hi, Mark.
Right, that was made in Dreams, but not what I wanted to show. I just found this video. Right, so new trailer. Dreams. Wow, that's big. His head is so big. Let's just make it somehow smaller. Can't fit it in. How can I do it? There we go. Perfect. May 19th. Are you still talking about Gorn? It comes out on Tuesday. So just wanted to show you, just to end this stream, bit of Dreams. Of course, as the time progresses, people making better games. They put out this video. Let's just change it to Dreams. Okay, so they put out this trailer just to thank the community, but also, of course, we all waiting for VR version. This is still on the roadmap and it's gonna happen. What you talking in the chat? It comes out on Tuesday. Oh, are you on about Gorn? Shook head, improvement of all PS VR games will be up the devs patching it. Yes. My bet is Gran Turismo gets a VR patch. That's my bet as well, so I definitely hoping so. Also, what I didn't know, I've been watching PSVR Without Parole Gamecast, and AJB saying you don't even have to play flat version. You can just play VR and unlock it like that. So I didn't know that, and the more you play VR, the more things you unlock without doing any flat racing. So I'm gonna hop into it fully in VR very soon. It was originally ruining the whole game, but the OG PS4 couldn't do it. That's right. Anyone know how much Gorn will be? Answers are in chat. I'm always in VR when you stream. Well, have to find time to play your VR games. Is there a Dreams disc copy? Yes, it is. You can buy it. You can order it. Go to Amazon or anywhere and you get it. To be frank, I think Dreams could have real promise when VR support is released. Yes, definitely. And just so you know, the VR support is not that far away. They put out on Twitter actually little video footage from the VR version. Actually, should we have a look? Do you want to have a look at some footage from VR patch? I don't know if I can find it now. Let's have a look. I try to find it, but I'm not sure if I can. I know it's on their Twitter somewhere, but it was a while ago. Right, let me try find it. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see, let's see. Right, that's from the molecule. I'm probably not gonna find it now. I need to go down quite a bit. Where is the dude from? Where is he? Right, okay. That's it. I found the developer, so let me see if we can find this footage. That's not it. That's not it. Sorry for that. I didn't expect it. Okay, found it. So that's the footage. Let me put it on full screen. I know it's gonna be a bit blurry, but okay, so that's the bit of showing like a lava or something, how it's gonna work and react to each other. But also they saying this gonna be added together with the VR update. So hopefully, and from looking at their Twitter, the VR update is very, very soon. So yeah, that's gonna be nice. Lava in VR, but also it looks like VR mode will be able to handle quite a bit of things. Shookhead, later guys, Paul, have a good show, buddy. Thanks, Shookhead. I'll be wrapping things up anyway. Daniel Mitchell, will it be third person VR like Astrobot or first person like Saints and Sinners or Blood and Truth? If you're talking about Dreams, whatever you make it, some people might make game which is third person, some people might make game which is first person. Whatever you imagine, you can make it in Dreams. Right, okay, so we just over an hour, but we managed to... Ooh, somebody's donated and I don't know who, so thanks a lot. Let me just see. Let me just see if I can find it. Right, okay, back to this. Thank you very much for donation, I've been looking. Max Anderson, thank you very much, super appreciated, and thanks for this nice emoji as well. This is awesome. Of course, as you know, all the donations go to the new capture card, because I've got this AverMedia, very good capture card, by the way. But sadly, with my laptop, it's not so good. So when I capture in things, I can capture them for the view with sound from the game, but I cannot capture them with me on it, on the screen, and also with my sounds from the microphone. That's why my playthroughs at the moment are captured with PSVR headset and PSVR mic, which does its job, but I would prefer to be like somewhere on the screen talking to you, so I can edit it a bit funnier and everything. So we shall see. Okay, what else in the chat? Hey Paul, I love your video. I hope you're gonna get famous one day, so everyone is informed about PSVR. Well, yeah, I hope so too. I'm here to spread the message for everyone. D-Bomb, I just joined in. Hi, and do you know if you will get Gorn demo before it's released? We don't get Gorn demo, but if you just joined in, I'll be wrapping things up in a minute. But if you rewind to the beginning of the stream, then you'll be able to see some PlayStation VR footage. Darcy, hey Paul, I love your work, it's very convenient, you're a legend. Thanks, thank you very much, appreciate all the comments. I love this new trailer from Dreams, by the way, I'm just watching it. People created so many fun stuff already and they just keep getting better and better. But anyway, I need to wrap things up because it's getting late. I'm gonna edit my Saints and Sinners video for you for tomorrow, and then I'm gonna go to bed because I'm working in the morning. And of course, don't forget Saints and Sinners giveaway on Sunday during PSVR Super Show. So once again, appreciate all the donations. I appreciate everyone who's popping into the streams, who comments, who likes, and just gets involved. It's always nice. It's always nice to read, and it makes more fun for me as well. So thank you very much, everyone, for watching. Yeah, that's it. Bye. I shall see you later once I figure out how to actually stop streaming. Because I did something to my computer, right? Get out of here. Okay, yeah, thanks for watching. That's it, bye, and appreciate everyone a lot. Bye-bye.